Hi, this is Jason Ferguson, and this is another video in our series, Learning E-Apps. Today we're going to cover Medico. So to use Medico's electronic application, you will need an account. You'll choose producers and either already an agent or become an agent. I'll say we're already an agent. And from here, if you've already registered, you can just click this button to continue. And you'll log in here, and if you don't have an account, you can register for one down here. After you log in, you will come to this screen, which is the agent portal homepage. And as a side note, there's a lot of good training info here for Medico. There's videos, PowerPoints, etc. There is a guide about My Enroller, and My Enroller is what Medico calls their electronic application system. And a nice thing about it is that it's not just MedSups. All of their products are integrated into this system. So to get started, you can either click the button here or go up to My Enroller at the top right. All right, now the first time you use this system, you will probably have to install a program called Citrix. And it'll pop up if you need to do that, but it's pretty painless. So it's also important to note you can use this online or offline. So if you don't have an internet connection, you can download this as a program to use on a laptop, for example. So you could fill out an application on your laptop and sync it up when you get back to the office or somewhere with an internet connection. But to get started, you'll click the Launch My Enroller Online button. And you may see another login screen, but in this case I did not. Next step, we'll click My Enroller. And this is going to open that Citrix viewer program that I had to install. And I'm on a Mac, you're most likely on Windows, so it might look a little bit different, but for the most part it will be the same. And the screen pops up with a login. Okay. So after we log in, if you have any incomplete submissions, they will be listed here, and your completed apps will be here. Since this is the first time using this, we're just going to say we're writing this in Illinois, and I'm going to choose my producer number, and then the new quote, new enrollment button appears. So I'll go ahead and click start new quote and or enrollment. And in this system, you'll see at the top a progress bar. This will start inching its way toward 100%. And this is a pretty thorough app. There's a lot of screens, but it's also pretty easy to use. The yellow fields represent required information. So if you see yellow, you have to fill it in. And we're going to say our client does not have email. Okay, when you're done filling that out, hit next. The next screen is for a household discount. If they are applicable, you would choose that. In this case, we're going to say no, this doesn't apply. So we'll just skip this screen. Then we get to the list of products. Remember, this isn't just MedSup. It's DVH, final expense, recovery, cancer, and hospital indemnity. So if we want to get a quote for Medicare supplement, we click the checkbox, and this lists products available in your state. We'll click Medicare supplement. So based on the information we've already entered on the previous screen, here are the results. So plan F, $148.70. We can change the payment mode to quarterly, and it updates down here. We'll leave that as monthly, and let's just say we're going to go with plan F. And our totals down here update instantly. So, for example, if you wanted to add a final expense plan, really easy to do. So you could say, I want a $10,000 plan, and it updates your premium at the bottom. Well, let's say that's more than your client wanted to spend. You can just uncheck that. It removes it instantly. Okay, so let's say plan F is all we need. We'll move on to the next screen. Let's say it's not open enrollment, It's not GI, non-smoker. Our client is, say, 5'10", 190. And click Next. Now, first off, you might notice there's a green field here. I mentioned yellow fields are for required info. Green fields are not required, but they're recommended. They really encourage you to fill the green fields out. And actually, any field you can fill out, you should. All right, we're going to say, we'll just fill in some info. We'll say, all right, moving on. You'll fill all this out as usual. I mean, it's the same stuff you're going to find on a paper app. We'll just say next. Let's say we do have another policy in force. It's with, we'll say Blue Cross Blue Shield. It was a Plan F. And we are going to replace it. We'll skip to the next screen here. Most of this I don't think I need to explain in detail. I mean, it's just going through the fields, answering the questions. And again, notice at the top, our progress is inching up higher. All right, so if we have other policies in force, we'd click Add Policy and put in the info. We're going to say None and None. All right, moving on. We'll say 401, 2015, and next. Okay, so this is the checklist. So fill this in as accurately as you can. I'm just kind of throwing some stuff in here that's not really accurate, but you'll want to fill that out as closely as you can. All right, the next step is the reason for replacement. We'll say lower premiums, and next, and the health questions. If you click yes for any, it's going to give you a message that you're not eligible for coverage. So we'll click yes, and it says ineligible. So let's just, these are all marked as no. And same thing here, make sure all those are no. And then we have prescription drugs. So if you don't want to type this out completely, you can kind of cheat by clicking, let's say we'll click on the S, and that's going to load up this list of drugs that start with S. So we can click the arrow, and there's a lot of drugs in the list. Or you can start typing. So we'll go simvastatin. Say that was prescribed . So once you put in the drug, you have to click Add Drug Info, and that's going to move it down here to the field. And so you can then do it again with additional drugs. So once you have all the drugs in there, click Next. Okay, home address. We'll say 7 p.m. Okay, we'll leave the rest of that blank for now. And this is the totals. And note that if you decide you want to add new products, you know, maybe you're having a discussion as you fill this out, you can always go back and go to the quote screen and add more products. So you can always access this menu at the top left and move throughout the application. But we're just going to leave this as a med sub and click Next. Okay, the agreement, this indicates that you can either email a link to download the Medicare Buyer's Guide, or you can give them a hard copy. If they agree to accept a link, you'll have to have their email address. So that's only for people with email. Otherwise, you'll have to click I've given them a hard copy. And then the policy delivery, let's say that's coming to the agent, and next. Okay, and here's the app as it would appear if it were on paper, only the handwriting is a little nicer than yours. Okay, so we can scroll through. You'll notice everything's in blue ink. And you can print this off for your records if you like. Although it's not signed yet, but you might see a little bar at the bottom like this. You could click save, or you could right click on it for the option to print. Okay, we'll just click next. Okay, and then you get a little blurb about the signature options. You can do an electronic signature with the applicant present. You can do it without the applicant present, but they must provide an email address. You can do voice authorization or paper. Okay, we're just going to click OK, and then we'll choose. And in this case, let's say we have our client present in our office. We can do the electronic signature. We'll choose that the applicant is present, which is fine. We don't have their email address, but we don't need one. At this point, you could turn your screen to face your client. They can click these if you like, or you can do it, in front of them so they can see. I agree that I've reviewed the above forms and agree to be bound by the terms and conditions. So they'll click yes, put in their date of birth. We'll move on to next. And then you have the option to split your commissions. We're going to say no. Next again. I certify the information. And next again. Okay, now if your client has an email address and you want to send them a copy of this, it's going to come as a PDF. Well, you may or may not be aware, email is not a secure way to send things. So that PDF is going to have their social security number and a lot of personal information. So Medico is putting a password on the PDF. So you would enter that password here. It's something you make up. So maybe you make it the first four digits of their last name and 123, whatever it might be. And then you'd enter their email address twice. Okay, we're going to say no email available. And click next. Bank draft option. All coverage, new and existing. We're going to say the info on their account is the same as the applicant, so it fills that in for us. The less typing we do, the better. And we're going to say, we'll say it's a checking account, and they are authorized to use the account. That's the last step. So we're going to stop here. If we complete the case, it would submit it as a real application, but this has only been a demo, so I'm not going to click that. So I can now close this, and you'll see if we click this little arrow, we have an incomplete submission. We haven't submitted that to underwriting yet. All right, so if we want to reopen the case, we can click this icon. If we want to delete it, we can click this. Most likely you're not going to delete cases, but I would encourage you to give this a shot. Just put in a test app, get familiar with how the system works, and then when you're ready to write one with a customer, you'll know how it works. So I would say give yourself a half hour to be on the safe side, but you can always get in and start one and come back to it later. So if you have any questions, let us know. I'll be happy to get you any answers that I can. Hope you guys find this useful. Thanks for watching.